tried with all my might, just can't win this fight. I'm slowly drifting, a vagabond. And just when I ran out of road, I met a man I didn't know, and he told me that I was not alone.
He picked me up, he turned me around, he placed my feet on solid ground. I thank the Master, I thank the Savior, because he healed my heart, he changed my name. Forever free, I'm not the same. I thank the Master, I thank the Savior, I thank God.
I cannot deny what I see. Got no choice but to believe. My doubts are burning like ashes in the wind. So, so long to my old friends. Burden and bitterness, you can't just keep it moving. No, you ain't welcome here. And now till I walk the streets of gold, I'll sing of how you saved my soul. This wayward son has found his way back home.
He picked me up, he turned me around, he placed my feet on solid ground. I thank the Master, I thank the Savior, because he healed my heart, he changed my name. Forever free, I'm not the same. I thank the Master, I thank the Savior, I thank God.
Wandering into the night, wanting a place to hide this weary soul, this bag of bones. And I tried with all my might, but I just can't win this fight. I'm slowly drifting, a bag of bones. And just when I ran out of road, I met a man I didn't know, and he told me that I was not alone.
He picked me up, he turned me around, he placed my feet on solid ground. I thank the Master, I thank the Savior, because he healed my heart, he changed my name. Forever free, I'm not the same. I thank the Master, I thank the Savior, I thank God.
I cannot deny what I see. Got no choice but to believe. My doubts are burning like ashes in the wind. So, so long to my old friends. Burden and bitterness, you can just keep it moving. No, you ain't welcome here. From now till I walk the streets of gold, I'll sing of how you saved my soul. This wayward son has found his way back home.
Up. He turned me around, he placed my feet on solid ground. I thank the Master, I thank the Savior, because he healed my heart, he changed my name. Forever free, I'm not the same. I thank the Master, I thank the Savior, I thank God. I am free. because he healed my heart. He changed my day. Forever free, I'm not the same. I thank the Master. I thank the Savior. I thank God.
Savior, because he healed my heart, changed my day forever. Savior, I thank God.
Wandering into the night, wanting a place to hide this weary soul, this bag of bones. And I tried with all my might, but I just can't win this fight. I'm slowly drifting, a vagabond. And just when I ran out of road, I met a man I didn't know, and he told me that I was not alone. He picked me up, he turned me around, placed my feet on solid ground. I thank the Master, I thank the Savior, because he healed my heart, he changed my name, forever free. I'm not the same. I thank the Savior, I thank God. Deny what I see, got no choice but to believe. My doubts are burning like ashes in the wind. So long to my old friend, burden and bitterness. You can't just keep it moving, no, you ain't welcome here. From now till I walk the streets of gold, I'll sing of how you saved my soul. This wayward son has found his way back home. He picked me up, he turned me around, the ground. I thank the Master, I thank the Savior, because he healed my heart, he changed my name, forever free. I'm not the same. I thank the Master, I thank the Savior, I thank God.
Forever free, I'm not the same.
Come on, saints. We're just starting to break through. We're just starting to break through the crowd. Let's don't stop just because the singers have stopped. Let's don't let that be something that holds us back. There's praise. There's more praise here. There's more glory to be given to God. There's more glory to be given to God. My God, we can never praise Him. We can never glorify His great name enough. Come on, saints. Come on, let's break through this. Come on. Come on. Can you feel that resistance here? Can you feel that resistance here? Let's break through that. Let's go right to the throne. Let's go through that. Let's go through that. Let's grab a hold of Him. Let's touch the hem of His garment. Come on, saints. Let's worship God. Let's glorify His great name. My God in heaven, He's here for us, saints. He's here for us. What do you have need of here tonight? What do you have need of here tonight? He's here. He's here to give you that. We don't have to hold back. We don't have to hold back. Well, my God in heaven, let's go get it. Let's ask Him for it. Let's ask Him for it. Let's seek Him like we've never sought Him before. Let's seek Him. Let's glorify His great name. Come on, saints. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Oh, the Shandani, the Bakashani, the Bakashani, the Bakashani.
Just when I ran out of road, I met a man. He's been good. 40 years of goodness in Maryville, Tennessee. We give God real good praise, exuberant praise. Hey, he picked me up and turned me around. That's why I gotta praise him. That's why I gotta magnify him. That's why I gotta exalt him, extol him, adore him, love him. He's so good. So, so, so good. Yes, you are, Jesus. Hallelujah. Clap your hand if you like what you feel, and you feel what you like. Hey.
We need to feel our praise in him tonight. And thanking him for getting up out of the tomb for us. I'm so glad that the cross couldn't hold him. The grave couldn't keep him. Death wasn't enough. Because he got up. And because he got up tonight, I feel like praising, praising him. Oh, I feel like praising, praising him. I'm gonna praise him in the morning. Praise him all day long. Because I feel like praising, praising him. Come on, church. Well, I feel like praising, praising him. Oh, I feel like praising, praising him. I'm gonna praise him in the morning. Praise him all day long.
He will fulfill it. So I don't know what tomorrow has to bring, but I know this. If He tells us to march around our Jericho, those walls are coming down. I know this, if he sets us in front of an impossible Red Sea, we're going to walk on dry land. And if he tells us to march in the battle and to face our giants, we might as well put our dancing shoes on because the battle has already been won. Our God is faithful, and we can trust his word, and we can stand on his promises, and we can declare that he is not a God who lies. So let's sing that again. Let's declare it in faith, speaking to that mountain, speaking to that giant. What's that?
There's not a mountain too tall. There's not a problem so small that Jesus can't resolve. In time he'll get involved. 'Cause our God, he cares about us. So thank you.
I'm at. I'm so thankful what the Lord has done. We sang that song, the first one, the heavens declare his glory, and it's true. But I'll always declare what he's done for, not man, but what he's done for me. What he's done for me, he turned this life around. And today, I thought we had a wonderful message today. Thank you, Brother Jonathan. And those statistics that he said should shake us. Sometimes we live in a bubble, I get that, and that's, you know, a safe place to be, but we just cannot stay there, saints. We just cannot stay there. And I just thought, Lord, stir something up. And, you know, Paul told Timothy, stir that which is in you. Stir it up. Shake me, Lord, shake me. Yeah. And as we were singing that song tonight, get up out of that grave, the Lord just said, Jerrod, get up out of that grave. Jerrod, get up out of that grave. And, Lord, I just... get me out of this grave. Shake me up, Lord, whatever it takes. I'm just so thankful to be here. I want to do whatever the Lord would have me to do. I just love each and every one of you, and I just wanted to say I'm just so thankful to be here. Thank you, Jesus.
Church all the time because that's where I love the Lord. I love him with all my heart. I've been through so much. I was in the hospital twice, 13 days. He brought me through that. Last time I was in there 7 weeks. I thought, oh God, are you still with me? He was like, he was over in the chair beside him, and he said, I'm here. I've never left you. The things I've been through, praise your holy name, God. Praise your holy name.
Thank you.
How much we've grown, how much I've grown since I've been here. And I had a dream one time that me and Michaela, I was on the sidelines and we were at this race. It was a marathon. And she had came over and she had been running and I was resting. I had a slushie with the cherry on top. And she had came over and I was like, here, sis, I left you some slushie. And he was like, you can even have the cherry that was on top. And I said, we got to get back running again. We can only rest for a little while. We got to get back running again. And we knew in our minds that we had the game plan. We had it down that we was going to go slow and steady so we wouldn't tire out. And that was our plan. We knew what to do. So we began running. And these guys, we were side by side. And these guys had ran past us really fast. And then we could have tried to run their pace. But we was like, no, we have the game plan. We're going to go slow and steady because he that endureth until the end, the same shall be saved. I want to run lawfully. There's rules to the race. You have to run lawfully to win that race. It's not how fast you get there, but it's just you finishing that race. And the only rules is that you have to run lawfully to obtain the prize. And we forget those things which are behind and we press. I want to press, and I have to repent because I have been slothful in my walk. I have grown content, and I think, how can I grow content with this power that we feel? But you can grow content with just what you have, but God wants to bless us so much more, but I don't think we're there yet, because Paul said, I must decrease so that you can increase, and he wants his kingdom come here in me. His will be done right here, right now. so thankful that he doesn't throw away the clay. I'm so thankful that he calls us to grow. We must grow. And I've been praying. I said, Lord, I want to be a better wife. Lord, I want to be a better mother. I do. I want to be a better servant to your body. And it was funny. I had went to this church and they had some books. And there was a woman after God's own heart. The next day I had found that book and I began to read it. And the part that hit me was, you have a heart. It was funny, before I found the book, the scripture that was on my mind that morning was, if you're neither hot nor cold, but if you're lukewarm, I'll spit you out of my mouth. And I thought, oh God, me? You know, I was actually surprised that I heard that. You know, and I think we can be so content to where when something like that comes along, you're like, oh me? You know, am I really there? Is that really me right now? And when I read that, it said, a woman after God's own heart is a heart that is on fire. And I read that in that book later on. And I was like, God, I don't want to stay this way, guys. I don't want to stay here. I don't want this church to stay here in this constant praise. And I think the enemy's trying to steal our worship. We have so much truth here, but if we lose our worship, guys, that breaks up that fallow ground. And that is what my calling is. I can say that my calling is to lead the children of God into worship and not lead in a way where the spotlight's on us. But I'm saying I want to usher in the Spirit. I want to be that vessel that just he can sing through me. He can use me as he wants to use me. And I think that that's a calling that God gives people. And I just want that to work. I want us to be sensitive in this house. So sensitive to what the Spirit's saying. Go pray for this one. Go lay hands on this one. And that's bearing one another's burdens. That's what you're feeling, what the other body is going through. I want to become so sensitive. If I have to fast, and that's a hard thing, I have to fast. I'm going to fast because the scariest thing is to stay in this place. The scariest thing is to stay the same. And that's not what I don't want to do. I don't want to stay the same. I have to go further in this, just like that race. You have to keep running. And if you think you've grown, then you'll never grow. If you think you've already grown enough, you'll never grow any more than what you've already grown. And that scares me to think that I've obtained already. I've not. I still have to grow. I still have so much to grow and so much to run. But I'm just thankful for this place. I really am. When I say I'm thankful for the leadership here, you don't know how many times I've had to message Pastor and say, Chandra, because I needed a word. I needed leadership. I needed to call on somebody that knew better than I was, that have lived longer than I have, that had a word of knowledge for me, that had wisdom to speak in my life from the Word of God. And that's the most important thing, that it was from the Word of God. It was through prayer. And I know they're not going to tell me something silly. And I'm so thankful for that. I'm so thankful for that safe haven. I'm so thankful for them. But I'm just so thankful for this place. I really am. I want to see God do great things with each and every person in here. I don't want us to grow stagnant. And I feel like God really is trying to shake us up, guys. I really do. I really do. And I'm like, God, just shake us up no matter what it takes. If you can turn the king's heart, you can turn this little heart. You can turn my heart. Oh, but I'm just so thankful. Let's grow, guys. Let's do this so that God can really give us the Tri-Cities. That's his promise. I want to see it come to pass in my lifetime. I haven't seen the power of God like others have seen it. Like Sister Robin, and they talk about it, and I haven't seen the power of God like that, but I want to see miracles like that. I want to see those signs and wonders, the true signs that this says, this sign shall follow them that believe. They will cast out devil in my name. They will speak with new tongues. They will lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. I want to see all these things even more come to pass. Thank you, Jesus.
I'm just so thankful for this place. I'm thankful for the word of God that came forth. And I'm so thankful for the worship that we have. And I was thinking of the scripture as Sister Ashley was speaking, where it's speaks in Revelation, they overcome by the testimonies of the saints. And that last part just says, those that love life, their lives unto the death. And the Lord was speaking that sometimes, you know, we do love our own life because we like our comfort zone. We don't want to get up before that anxiety just stands up before us, you know. And that's our comfort zone, where we sit still and do nothing. But we can't sit still and do nothing. And I'm like Sister Ashley, I want to see us go forth. I want to see that worship grow stronger. I want to see the move of God go stronger. And I was thinking, it's been a couple of weeks, and I was praying. I said, Lord, I'm so tired. I'm so tired of the same old thing, doing the same old thing, and everything just remaining the same. And the Lord said, well, you need to do something different. And so, but it's not in our nature to do anything different. We want that same thing. We want that comfort. We want to sit back and wait on somebody else to do it. But I am so thankful for where I am. And I was thinking about that dream at the same night that I prayed. He gave me this dream. And it was so real. And I woke up from that dream, and it just felt like I was still in the presence of the Lord. But we was in this church. I mean, it was filled to the brim. And the Spirit of God was moving. It was going wave after wave. And this man got up, his son. It was like he was had a, you know, a mental disability, and he was praying. They had him down front, and they was praying for him. And all of a sudden, he started screaming. And his father was there with him, and he started screaming. He's running out of the church. And his father was running behind him. Pastor was running behind his father, and my grandson Caleb, which was up there with him, he ran outside behind the three of them, and his mom was running outside behind him because she was trying to stop him because, you know, she's why he was running. But, and I thought of where when they got outside, and all of a sudden this building all of a sudden was next door, and the man ran inside of this building, and his father went in behind him. And the next thing you know, this man come flying out of the building because the son, he had a spirit, and he had threw his father and he out of the building, and he went flying across the street. And pastor kept saying, did you hear what he said? That's a spirit talking. That's not him. And so, but the man didn't want to hear that his son had a spirit. So when he threw his father across the street, pastor went running to go see about this man. And just as he was running, this car tried to run him over. And you could see the spirits. And this reason why, as Brother Jonathan spoke, we need to put on that whole armor. Because you could see the forces moving this car. And all of a sudden, it just like it was trying to run over past it, and all of a sudden it went another direction. And then as we turned to go back inside of this church, you could feel the Spirit of God. It was just a wave after wave was moving. I mean, the praises went up. It was so strong. I mean, it was just going one wave after another one. And this sister got up, and she started singing her testimony. And when she started singing her testimony, the Spirit of God went up again. And you could just feel the Spirit of God. It was moving so strong. And after that wave, and then this brother, he got up and he started blowing this ram's horn, just like a trumpet. And the Spirit of God began to move again. And I tell you, it was so strong, and it was so powerful. And it's just like you couldn't explain it. I don't even have the words to describe the Spirit of God that was moving at that time. And then Brother Earl, he got up, and he started expounding on the Word of God, what that ram's horns mean when they blow the horn. And I had to go look that up myself. You know, when I woke up in this dream, I wanted to know what it was when they blew that horn. And each time they blew that horn, because God told Joshua they blew the ram's horn when they marched around Jericho, when the walls came down. They blew that horn when they was in victory, when they went to battle. And so the Lord is letting us know that horn is blowing for us. When he gave us that scripture, blow the trumpet in Zion, it's time for this church to stand up. And we will see the Spirit of God. And I just say, I'm just so thankful that God is in a place that where he is showing us that he's going to move. And as Job said in his spirit, it says that he was going to pour out his spirit on all flesh. And say, your sons and your daughters, your old men and your young men, he's not just going to pour it out on just the prophets and the ministers, but he's going to pour it out on you. He's going to pour it out on your children. You will see them rise up and stand up and testify the word of God. And I so look forward to that day. And I just like Sister Ashley, I want to see that happen in my lifetime. I want to see my grandchildren stand up and preach the word of God. I want to see your children stand up and testify the goodness of God. And I am so thankful for where I am. And I just praise God for everything that he's doing among us.
When Brother Jonathan was preaching this morning, at the end where he was telling us to look all inward and look at, you know, where we are and the gifts that is, you know, the Lord may be trying to manifest in us, and we're truly where we may be falling short. I've read the scripture probably, I don't know, a couple, 20 times or more, but, you know, everybody should know this scripture where the two brothers were asked to do something by the father, and one son said, no, I won't go, and the other son said, yes, I would, and the one that said he wouldn't go actually went out and did the work, and the one that said he would go did not do anything, you know, and Ashley was just saying in her testimony where, you know, if you're lukewarm, the Lord will spew you out, but, you know, in relationship to that, we say these things of, we want to see the Lord move, and we want to see, you know, those signs and wonders follow as it says in the word of God. But just going back to Jonathan's message, we have to look inward. You know, when we say those declarations out loud that we want to see these things and we'll do whatever it takes, is our yeses really being yeses? And, you know, are we that son that says, yes, we'll do it? And then we turn around and do nothing, and we sit around and we don't do what it takes for the Spirit of the Lord to enter this place, for the Spirit of the Lord to dwell in this place. I mean, the Lord has really been working on me, you know, as a mother, as a woman of God, as the one that, you know, is in charge of the kids' ministry. Am I really willing to do what it takes? And I remember I had been writing this poem of the Flame's Daughter, and I could never finish it. I probably started it back in 2018, and I would write a line, and I couldn't write anymore, you know, and I was looking at this poem the other day, Keep Me Close to the Flame, you know, the words in this poem, and we say those things of keep me close to the flame, Lord, and it's easy to make those declarations when everything's going okay. It's easy to make those declarations when we don't have to fight and we don't have to push ourselves. And it's easy, you know, to come into the house of the Lord and dance like we did tonight when we're not carrying that burden. But what about those times where we do have to push? And what about those times when life just seems hard? Are we still willing to come in here the same way that we would? Because as we said time and time again, I remember we had that banner on the old church of, it's not how you feel, it's what you know. You know, we were once, as that song that we were singing, get up, get up, get up, get up out of that grave, dance out of those grave clothes. We were all once dead men's bones walking around. We were all once without no hope walking around. And I think we forget that. We forget that the Lord had to
rescue us. The Lord had to come in time and time, not just one time, not just two times, not just three times, but time and time again and rescue us and pull us out of that pit over and over again. Maybe you haven't had that experience, but he's done it for me over and over again. There have been times where I wanted to give up, and I felt like serving the Lord was just hard. It was hard, and I don't know how I thought in my mind that, you know, once I start serving the Lord, it would just be better. And then I thought, okay, well, that didn't work. Well, once I get the Holy Ghost, it'll be better. Okay, that didn't work. Well, once, you know, I get to this stage, it'll be better. It's a battle each and every day. It's a battle, but we have to stand on this word. It's not what we feel. It's what we know. There is a hope that lies before us, just in Ashley's testimony, that if we keep going, we will reach that. We will reach that hope that we pray for, that we strive for. But we have to do some looking inward at ourselves and looking at why aren't we seeing that? What is in me that is not allowing the Spirit of God to move? What is in me that is maybe hindering my brother or my sister from going further in the Lord than what they should be go? Because it's not just about ourselves. I just want to see everybody in here make it. I want to see everybody in here see those signs and wonders. I want to see everybody in here from in my church days, you know, being slain in the Spirit, you know, not having to press so hard, you know, to get the Spirit moving, not having to have a hype person to talk about what the Lord has done for them in the middle of a song service. We all were once wretched and poor. We halfway still are. We have not attained that glory as of yet. And so if we have to press so hard knowing what the Lord has done for us, we're one of those sons or one of those daughters where we said, yes, yes, Lord, we'll do it. Yes, Lord, we'll go out and do what you say. But we turn around and just sit there and be quiet and not doing what we said that we would do. If we say that we're going to give our all, then give her all, because it's going to turn back to us where we say, Lord, keep me closer to the flame. And he's going to keep putting you to the flame until you say, yes, Lord. And so that declaration that we keep saying, I remember I would give that testimony of offering, of how it was so hard for me in the beginning and how Pastor had preach that message of being a thief if you're not giving an offering. And it hurt me. Like, how dare he call me a thief and, you know, all these things. But, you know, when I was doing okay and, you know, finances wasn't a mess, it was easy to give an offering. I would go up there joyfully. Yeah, I got my 10%. I'm good. Thank you, Lord. But, you know, here recently, it just seemed like everything just piled on me financially, and I had this to pop up and this to pop up. And, you know, I was looking at that 10% like, you know, wait a minute now, you know, Lord, do you really need this? You know, can I really give this? Can I really afford to give this? And so there was a week that I didn't give. And it pressed on my heart until the next payday. It really did, you know, that I did not give that 10%, even though I had it and these other things were coming up. But I kept saying, well, Lord, if I pay this, you know, this bill is due. I got to, you know, get this kid's school fees. I got to do this, and I got to do all these things. And so if I pay that, I'm going to be without. I'm going to be without. So I didn't do it. And it hit, I mean, that entire two-week span until I got paid again, it really hit my heart that I did not pay that 10%. And so, again, the next, thank you, Lord, yes. And then this payday came around again, and here I am still in the same bubble. You know, the bills didn't just magically go away within that 2 weeks. I still have, you know, the same bills. I still have the same responsibility, and I look at my kids, and they're growing out of everything. You know, so I had that decision to make again. It stayed on your heart that full 2 weeks. Are you going to do the same thing again, or are you going to trust in the Lord that says that he will never leave you or forsake you, that he will make a way when there seems to be no way? And so I was like, okay, Lord, you know, I got to put my mouth to the test of what I declare over and over again, that I can trust in the Lord. So I'm just going to go ahead and pay my tithes and leave it at that. I'm going to pay them joyfully the same way that I would when I wasn't struggling. And so, you know, I paid the tithe, and, you know, I was able to pay my school fees, was able to pay, you know, the other fees with New Hope, were able to get groceries, able, you know, and I'm looking like, where is this money coming from? Because I know how much I made, and I know, you know, all my bills that were due and how much they were. Where was this money coming from? I didn't have anything that could cover the bills, but just, you know, I got, it just, the Lord just provided, is all that I can say. The Lord provided to where I didn't have to worry about, you know, those bills that were stressing me out. I didn't have to worry about, you know, getting food for the kids, and I didn't have to worry about all these things that are my financial responsibility, because I just trusted in the word of the Lord, you know, with giving my tithes, because that's what I am required to do. It's not even what I owe him. I owe him so much more. But that's just, you know, the 10% is what he requires of me to do. So I'm just so thankful with each message that comes forth, even going back to Brother Jimmy's when he preached on Wednesday. You know, it kind of tied into what Brother Jonathan was preaching today. You know, we have that responsibility not just to ourselves. We have that responsibility to this ministry. And I'm just so thankful for each and every one of you guys. As much as I say that, you know, I like to be alone and I don't like to call people. I remember when COVID was, when we were actually had to stay at home. And I was actually like, hey, what are you doing? I miss you guys. Let's start, you know, a chat to where we could all talk to each other. You know, and that made me realize, no, I don't dislike people. You know, I may like to stay to myself, but I actually like each and every one of you guys to the point that, you know, when I don't see you, I do miss you. And I do, you know, pray for you and, you know, wonder how you're doing. And, you know, you come up in my mind. So I'm so thankful for this place. I'm so thankful for this group of people that the Lord has placed me with. I'm thankful for our leadership and pastor, just our leadership, you know, Sister Sandra, you know, with just striving for excellence in everything that they do with this garage sale that we just did with the church for the school. Just seeing Sister Sandra come day in and day out, whether she had help, whether somebody else came, whatever it was, she was here every single day. And she would come early in the morning, and she would leave late at night. She came back on Friday, you know, and worked till 1 o'clock in the morning, you know, and then got back up. She beat me here. You know, I got up at 6. I don't know what time she got up. Oh, my goodness. I don't even want to think about that, but she was here when I got here, and we got here at 7:30, you know. So just that dedication that we have from our leadership should store something up in us. They can't do it by themselves. They can't, these two people that the Lord has placed over us, they can't do all this by themselves. They have to have us to lend in that helping hand. You know, as Jimmy was talking about on Wednesday, you know, we need to show up when they're here, when we're having gatherings. You know, if we're tired or whatever, if we have something else, you need to reschedule. This is where our help comes from. So why can't we help when it has something to do with the church? There were things that I wanted to do that I could have just did it, but I had to reschedule it. No, we're having a church function where we need to be here and we need to serve the house of God. You know, and that just goes back to let my yays be yays. You know, when we say that we'll do it for, you know, our church, we'll put in work for our church. Where are you? Where are you when the church functions are there? You know, where are you when, you know, you're in the Mully Grubs? Pastor had to message me for the 4th of July picnic. He, you know, he texted me like, hey, where were you? And I was like, you know, I was kind of, you know, in my feelings. I didn't really feel like being bothered with everybody, you know, with some things going on. And he was like, that's fine, that's great. But, you know, you could have came, and this is where you could have found your help. You know, we could have lifted you up during that time. You know, we could have prayed over you. We could have, you know, give you encouragement of what you were going through rather than you sitting at home moping because the situation's not going to change because you decided to stay at home moping, but you could have been in the house of the Lord, you know, here in the picnic, and you could have got that encouragement that you needed. You know, just that little rhyme, I was like, you know, you're right. I could have did that, and I apologize that I wasn't there, you know, and I'll try to make better choices. I can't make any promises. But, you know, just that thing that we don't look at the church for. But you guys are my help. You guys do lift me up when, you know, things are going on in my life. You guys are the people that I turn to when I do need advice, just as Sister Ashley was saying. You guys are the ones that I seek prayer for when things are going on with myself or my kids or, you know, whatever the case may be. So, again, I just go back to let my yeas be yeas. When I say that I'm going to do what I need to do for this church, for this congregation, for the saints of God that are here, you know, let me not turn my back on you guys, you know, and be like the parable where he says you were hungry and you didn't feed them, those things. I want to be, you know, one of those dependable ones where if you are in need, I'm not saying, well, I can't take no phone calls, text me. No, you may need to speak, you know. So just let my yeas be yeas. Let my declarations that I say out loud be a living testimony in me. Not it just be words that I say to make myself look good, you know, or make myself look like a better Christian. I actually want to exemplify those things that I say. You know, I actually want to do those things when I say that, you know, this is my place, this is my people. You guys truly are my people, and this truly is my place.
We might have time for one more quick testimony. Maybe one of our young people or something that haven't testified or somebody hadn't testified in a while. Anybody? Okay. Maybe I missed it there. I thought for sure there was one testimony out there. But it was good that we were here this day, wasn't it? My goodness, what a day. Started with Brother Jonathan and his message today and ended here tonight in such a wonderful way. We're just, I've said it before and I've told you, I'm going to continue to say it. This is a wonderful place. We're so many people have desired to see the things that we have seen and hear the things that we hear and have not. And we're just so blessed to have this, and we're so blessed to have the leadership that we do. Each and every day, I really appreciate Sister Ashley said. She said, I want to learn to be a better servant. And that should be all of our hope. That should be all of our desires to be a better servant. A servant and his master were out in the field, and they were working. And when they came in, it says, does the servant serve himself, or does he serve his master? Does he serve his master first? See, so many times this world doesn't even understand something like that. They don't even understand that we would want to be a better servant. What are you talking about? But here was a servant. When they come in from the field, no doubt they'd had a long day. No doubt it had been a rough day. If you've ever worked out in a field, the dirt and the dust and the heat and the sun, my goodness, but yet he come in and he began to serve his master, and then he went and ate. That's the hope that we should all have. That's the desire, because that's what our master did for us. He served us when he didn't feel like it. As Sister Leslie said, when he didn't feel like it, when she didn't feel like it, she gave her tithe, because that's her obligation. That's where the Lord really finds out where you're at. What's going on in here? It's not in the good times. And in the bad times, sometimes all you can do is just stretch forth your hands and let another gird thee. Because there's going to be bad times, as people have said. But, you know, that goals, Sister Ashley, that end. See, Brother Terry called me an old man tonight, which I guess he can. But see, I'm drawing close to 70 years old. But I'm still in this race. I'm still in this race. I'm not complete yet, or the Lord would have taken me. See, when he gets us complete, then he takes us. He takes us. I've said many times, I sat on my, whatever you call it, veranda, your patio, your porch, whatever you want to call it. My one on the east side of the house, I sit there many, many mornings and watch the sun come up. And oh, how I want to see him. Look upon his face. The one who saved me by his grace. You know, I've instructed Sister Cheryl. She hates when I say this, but when I pass away, there's one song I once sang for sure. Well, there's two songs. First one's Amazing Grace. And the second one's I'll Meet You in the Morning. I'll meet you in the morning. Just inside that eastern gate. I'm looking forward to that. I so want to see him. He's done so much. This has been a glorious time, as I said. It's so good to be in the house of God. It's so good to worship with each one of you. It was so good. I'm sorry, I don't know your name, sister. Mary. Sister Mary, it was so good to worship with you here tonight. I saw this sister down there with her hands reached into the heavens. And tears streaming down her face. Lord, how I love to worship with God's people. How I love to worship with God's people. We're fellow soldiers. It said, and I wasn't in the military, but it said, if you serve on the battlefield with men, there's something. You go so very close. I've never served in the military, but I've served on the battlefield. When I look around here, I see some of you and I see the battles that you've went through. My heart goes out to you. See, I have something so very in common with each and every one of you because of the battles. I don't know your battles, all of them, and you don't know my battles, all of them. But oh, we've served together on the battlefield. We've served together on the battlefield. There'll be times like Jonathan. He came up to a lentil field one time. And it was just a lentil field. But he said to his armor bearer, he said, let's see what the Lord will do. Let's see what the Lord will do. Let's see if he'll give us a victory. There's going to be times when you'll have to stand in that lentil field by yourself and battle. But you know something? If you're with the Lord, if you're with him, the battle will be great. There will be such a victory come out of that, and the glory will go to him. See, we can't take glory for anything we do in this life. If I have anything, it's because of him. If I do anything, it's because of him. Where I started from, you would never guess that I would even be standing behind a pulpit. But he's been so good. He's been so good. So at this time, I think we're going to take an offering. Brother Jimmy, you can just come by yourself. I'd like to say this. I appreciate Sister Leslie's testimony, how she gave her tithes when she didn't think she could do it, and the meal barrel never ran out. I've been in that situation myself, Sister Cheryl and I have, and it's you learn to trust God. That's the times you really see God's word come to pass. You see it come to pass. And we have financial obligations. I know the school's starting. We took in a goodly number Saturday, $900. And that sounded like a lot of money, but you can look at Sister Chandra's face and go, ooh. A lot of money goes out. And it's not just poured out on the ground. It's used to better these children, to have a good education. When we come into the church, we just took up an offering for the heat pump for that school. Some of it come in, some of it didn't. So for those that made an obligation, go ahead and send it in. Be careful when you make a vow to the Lord. Go ahead and make the vows. Go ahead and make the vows. But be careful. Be careful what you make a vow. Because he hears. He hears. You might have just said it in secret, but he hears. So each and every time that we come together, the lights are on, the air conditioner's on. Sometimes it don't feel like it. When we were shouting tonight, you just go, oh, is the air conditioner broke down? But thank God for air conditioning. Thank God for air conditioning. So let's just all stand here and we'll pray, ask the Lord to bless this offering. If we give our whatever we can, the Lord will make up the difference. It's in his word. He'll make up the difference. So let's pray here. Dear Heavenly Father, we're so thankful, O Lord God, for the service that we came through, O Lord God. We're so thankful for, O Lord God, for each and every individual, O Lord God, that came together here tonight, O Lord God, fellow soldiers in this war, O Lord God. We're just asking right now, O Lord God, that you would, as we take up this offering, that you would bless it, O Lord God, that you would move upon these mites, O Lord God, that are dropped in the offering, and that you would stretch them out, O Lord God. We're just thankful, O Lord God, for each and every individual that drops those. In Jesus' precious name, amen. All right, as Jimmy comes forward, and we have a little music. God bless you in this offering.
My arms that reach me and love that keeps me. Yeah.
Father, we just thank you for this time, Lord. Father God, in your presence there's fullness of joy, Father God. In your presence there's peace, Father God. In your presence, Father, Lord Jesus, God, chains fall down. Father God, healings take place. As Lord God, we were praying for our sister Mary here tonight, Father God. And Lord, you gave me that miracle Mary. She is a miracle Mary. You have healed her. They've told her she was supposed to be gone years ago, Father God. But Lord, your sustaining grace and your healing power has carried her, Father God, and has proved that, Father, Lord Jesus, you are the author and the finisher of our faith, Father God. You are the almighty God. You are the omnipotent, Father God. You have the very life and breath that we breathe in your hand, Father God. And we thank you for that, Lord. We love you. We praise you. Thank you for the testimonies, Father God, of your faithfulness tonight. Father God, oh Lord Jesus, you are a God that never fails. You are so consistent, Father God, and we love you and we praise you, Father God. We ask that you would keep Pastor Jerrod safe as he comes back, Father God, home. And Lord, thank you for using him, Father God. Continue to open up doors, Father God. And we ask right now that you would give everyone here a wonderful week, Father God. Father, we ask for right now that you would use us for your glory and for your honor and your power. May we win souls to your kingdom, because he who wins souls is wise. And we know you're coming back soon. And what we do, we've got to do it quickly, Father God. So, Father, anoint us, because it is not us, but you who get the glory. We are nothing without you, Father God. We want your anointing power to flow through us and speak through us, Father God, and work through us, so that, just like Ashley said, so that we can win these tri-cities and we can win Tennessee and Virginia. We can win this nation, Father God, to you. And we thank you, we praise you, we give you the glory. Thank you for the words that have come forth from Brother Jonathan today, Father God, from all those who have, Lord Jesus, God, spoke what you have asked him to speak. We love you, we praise you, go with us, and we give you the glory and the praise and the honor. In Jesus' name we ask it. Hallelujah, amen, amen.